Welcome, student. Today we are going to see about the behavior of electric conductor in, say, in an external electric field. External electric field means the field lines will go this way. Let us assume a uniform electric field. Now, when we are keeping a conductor, conductor means what? It has got excess of free electrons in it, and it has got equal number of positive charge and equal number of negative charge in it. So electrically it is neutral. We can say the net electric field inside a conductor is equal to zero. Now let us assume this is a conductor and it will have plus minus charge and excess electron also. When we apply an external electric field on the both side of the conductor. This is conductor. This is conductor. If you apply external field, what will happen? This side is positive, this is negative. So this will be positive and this will be negative. So this positive charge, when it is put in the conductor, what it will do? So this positive charge will attack all the electrons this side, and this negative charge will attack all the positive charges in the conductor. It means an induced positive charge. This is induced positive charge in the conductor. This is also induced negative charge. So what is the direction of electric field? Electric field is from positive to negative. This is electric field applied electric field, that is equal to electric field. Now, since this positive charge is attracted all the negative charge, that is electron in this direction, and this negative charge of this external electric field attracted all the positive charge in the conductor this side, the charges are induced and this process will continue. So left side, this is the, in the left side it is positive, in the left side negative charge is induced, and the right side the positive charge is induced in the conductor. This process, how long will it continue? Till this process will continue. It means that what is the electric field inside? Electric field inside, that is electric field induced. EI is equal to induced electric field. Induced electric field. It is in this direction, and the direction of applied electric field is in this direction. So now, this process of induced charges will continue till an electric field due to induced charges is set up. So, which is equal and opposite. The induced both electric field and EI are equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction. Since both are equal and opposite, we can write applied electric field is equal to negative of electric field induced, or polarized. Charges is brought from here to here because it is split up, and all the charges are induced, negative induced here, positive induced there. Or we can say E is my plus EI is equal to zero. It means the net electric field inside a conductor is zero when this conductor is placed in an external electric field. Net electric field inside a conductor is equal to zero when placed in a external electric field. This is the first property we have discussed. Next point, just inside the surface of the conductor, the electric field is normal. just outside the surface of conductor, the electric field is normal to its surface. So if this is a conductor, the electric field either will be normal or it will be like this. If it is for negative charge, it will be like this. For positive, it will emerge out. Suppose positive, if it is coming like this, it will not go inside, because inside the electric field is equal to zero, and it will not, the lines will not be visible here, it will not be seen here, and it will be outside. And same way, it will be perpendicular. So the just outside the surface, this is outside the surface of the conductor, the electric field is normal to its surface. Electric field lines are, that is, electric field lines are perpendicular to the surface. Third point is net charge inside the conductor. Net charge inside the conductor is equal to zero. What is net charge? See, this is the conductor. Let us take any type of shape. Inside electric field is equal to zero. Conductor. So by Gauss law, surface integral of electric field lines is equal to charge inside the conductor divided by epsilon naught. Since inside the conductor, we know just first point, electric field is equal to zero. It means this portion is equal to zero. So integral surface of zero dot ds. This we can write it this way also. Surface integral E into it, this is a dot product of vector E into ds into cos of angle between E and d theta is equal to charge inside by epsilon naught. We can write this way. Since this portion is equal to zero, so dA into zero into cos theta is equal to charge inside by epsilon naught. It means this entire portion will become zero, whatever the value of dS may be, because this is cannot be zero. Zero multiply anything is equal to zero. It means zero is equal to charge inside divided by epsilon naught. Epsilon cannot be zero, it is a constant whose value is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9. So charge, what happened to charge inside? Zero. This has become charge inside is equal to zero. It means charge inside, electric field also equal to zero, charge inside is equal to zero. Then what happens? Charge inside is equal to zero. So charge is inside, charge is already there inside the conductor, but it cannot stay inside. If it cannot stay inside, what will happen? It will stay on the outer surface of the conductor. Suppose it will stay, what positive charge means, it will stay. So we can see charge, if it is given positive charge, charge will remain on the surface of the outer surface of the conductor. 2 point, we have seen electric field inside is equal to zero, hence charge is also zero. This we can prove in another way. So what is electric field? Electric field is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into source charge divided by r square. So since this is equal to zero, then q, whatever q, q will also be equal to zero, because this is not equal to zero, the distance is not equal to zero, q is equal to zero. But we can say potential. What is potential? Potential is equal to k into q by r. If charge is zero, potential, can it be zero? No, it cannot be zero. This we will see in the next point. Next point, electrical potential is constant and is equal to potential at the surface of the conductor. What he says, electric field, suppose this is the center and it is having a distance r. What is potential at the surface? Potential at the surface is equal to k into, it is given a charge of q divided by r. It is on the surface, and inside, v inside also is equal to v inside also, v on the surface. That is the point. That is everywhere. and whatever potential is available on the surface is same potential is available everywhere inside of the conductor. So now let us see, we know this relation, electric field dv by dr is equal to minus e. It means electric potential is the negative potential gradient. Potential gradient, variation of potential with respect to distance is called potential gradient, is equal to negative of potential gradient is equal to electric field. It means along the direction of electric field, the potential decreases. It means electric field is in this direction, potential will be increasing in the direction, negative relation. Or we can say dv by dv is equal to minus e into dr. Inside the conductor, e is equal to 0. Or we can write dv is equal to minus 0 into dr. Or dv is equal to 0. On integrating both the sides, we get integration of dv is equal to, this is differentiation, integration cancels out, v is equal to integration of a constant, integration of 0 is equal to a constant. You see, integration of constant, integration of 4e is equal to 0, because we are differentiating with respect to x. So differentiation of constant is equal to 0. It means integration, if you integrate both the sides, this integration differentiation cancels out because both are a reverse process. So this is a constant. So integration of constant, integration of 0 is equal to a constant. Integration of 0 is equal to a constant. So potential is constant means what? Potential is constant. So on the surface is equal to k into q divided by r. And same is available in this point also. What is V surface? In this point also V surface. Means the potential at this inside a conductor is equal to, is same as what the potential is at the surface of the conductor. This is the point. So it means we can do one thing, we can see, realize one thing, electric field inside the conductor is equal to 0, charge inside the conductor is equal to 0, but potential is constant, which is equal to what is available at the surface. Next point, electric field at the surface of a conductor is sigma by charge density divided by epsilon naught. Suppose if you take a conductor here, this is a conductor, and we will construct a Gaussian surface, that is at this point Gaussian surface. We can construct a cylindrical surface, because Gaussian surface and inside also we have to construct inside also. So this is the Gaussian surface at this distance, some distance of r, and here also the same distance. Since electric field inside the conductor is equal to 0, electric field inside, and we got to this point, we will take a small area ds, and ds vector is perpendicular to this surface, this side face. And electric field, if it is given a positive charge, the conductor, now since electric field inside is equal to 0, and we got one more surface here and one surface here, so we call it as a small surface, and ds vector this side, and the electric field will be in this direction because it will be radiating outwards. And for this is ds, and this is ds vector. Ds vector is always perpendicular to the surface. So electric field here will be in this direction. Now since electric, we got one, two curved surface, on this side one surface, this side one surface, this surface. So by Gauss law we can write it as surface integral of electric field lines dot product is equal to charge n side divided by epsilon naught. This is by Gauss law. But we got one surface here. Since here this surface can be written as like this, for this surface, this is for one, this is for two, and the curved surface, this side face, this side face. So this we can write E dot ds for surface one plus this curved surface, integral surface two E dot ds vector plus for this surface, this side facing side. So integral E dot, that is surface 3, integral E dot ds is equal to charge n side by epsilon naught. Now this can be written as E, what is this ds vector is in this direction, electric field is in this direction, electric field. But here inside the electric field is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. So 0 into dot ds is equal to 0 plus this one for the surface 2. This is the surface, second surface. Here electric field, integral E into ds into cos, the angle between electric field vector and ds vector. This is the electric field vector this way, and ds vectors in this direction, surface, small surface vector in this direction, cos 90 degrees plus this is E into ds and electric field and ds vector in the same direction into cos 0 is equal to charge divided epsilon naught. Since this is 0 and cos 90 is equal to 0, so this will be also 0. And this portion is equal to E into integral ds is equal to charge divided by epsilon naught. So integral, what is integral? Integration of small portion is equal to, see, integral of ds is equal to total area. So total area. So we can write this portion E into total area of the conductor is equal to charge divided by epsilon naught, or E is equal to charge divided by A into 1 by epsilon naught. See, as it is, we know surface charge density is equal to charge divided by area. Surface means area, so this will become E into this portion will become surface charge density divided by epsilon. This is the magnitude of electric field in a conductor. So electric field at the surface of the conductor is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. So, and direction of electric field will be perpendicular surface of the conductor, and magnitude of electric field is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. This is the, so electric field at the surface of the conductor is sigma by epsilon naught, and the electric field lines are perpendicular. It means the electric field lines will be perpendicular to the surface. This is the surface, perpendicular. In this surface, it will be perpendicular.